starting simple with a single element. As you can see, this chair in the bedroom is facing the wrong direction. To rotate it 90 degrees, simply select the element and press Ctrl R for Windows or Command R for Mac. This new shortcut provides a quick way to adjust the orientation, saving you 4 steps compared to the regular rotate command. Let's see how this works with multiple elements. Imagine you want to reorient an entire office layout: desk, chairs, and shelf. Select all elements, then use Ctrl R or Ctrl Shift R. The entire group rotates around the center point of your selection, making it easy to maintain the arrangement and alignment of all elements at once. In this example, we have a unique design challenge. The wall adjacent to this exterior stair needs to slope down following the stair's inclination, starting with the sloped wall. We need to remove a triangular shape from the wall element so that it follows the stair's inclination, aligning with its profile. First, select the opening tool and set it to a polygonal shape with an infinite limit. This way, the opening cuts through the entire wall thickness. Next, we create the opening itself. This can be done by clicking node by node and manually drawing the polygon. This method gives you the exact result you want. You can see how flexible and intuitive the opening tool is, even for complex or non-parallel surfaces in section. In this project, 2 bedrooms will be combined into a single living area as part of a refurbishment. All model elements here are already classified with the correct renovation status: existing, to be demolished, or new. You'll notice there are 2 interior elevation markers in the original bedroom layout. However, when we switch to the planned status, these markers no longer make sense, since the room shapes have changed completely. To keep the documentation accurate, select these interior elevation markers and set their renovation status to be demolished. As you can see, they are now only visible with renovation filters where the to be demolished elements are shown, and they are overridden by the renovation graphic override rule, which makes elements yellow. As you switch between renovation filters, the markers appear and disappear accordingly, ensuring your drawings always reflect the correct project phase. Here, we have a view index displaying all used and unused project views. In ongoing projects, it can be difficult to distinguish between them. To clarify which views are not placed on layouts versus those not included in publisher sets, open the index settings. Click Add Fields, and under View, you'll find Included in Publisher Set and Placed on Layout. Add them both and click OK. With these checkboxes, it's easy to identify unused views, even in projects with thousands of saved views. To filter only the unused views, let's go back to Index Settings and click the Add Criteria button. Under Layouting, you'll find the criteria Included in Publisher Set and Placed on Layout. Add both as criteria, keep their values to false. This way, the list will show the views not included in a publisher set and not placed on a layout. So both of the checkboxes are empty.